Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I'm Sayyid Ali Imran with Mizan Institute. Please join me on August 21st and August 22nd for a presentation on the origins and development of Aza Muharram commemorations. Inshallah, this presentation will be of two parts. In the first part, we'll be discussing the overall history and what exactly happened immediately after the Battle of Karbala itself, and how the Imams alayhim as-salam themselves played a role in institutionalizing the practice of Aza, and how they wanted it to become part of the Shia community's cultural identity. Some of the slides will cover exactly what happened, and how the Imams were encouraging gatherings in houses, and how they were encouraging poets to come and mourn for Imam al-Hussein. Later on, we will discuss how the Aza evolved in different periods when the Shia communities were living under different political dynasties. Some of the things I'll also cover are images and paintings that are preserved in different museums around the world. Some pictures are also pictures that I took myself during my travels in Iran from the Qajar period, for example. And we'll talk about some of these images and what they're depicting. For example, this image over here from around 110 years ago of somebody reciting in a Husseiniya or a Taqiyyah, which we will discuss as well, in Iran. Another interesting slide that we will cover is where I will play clips from the Azadari rituals from a period of where the end, basically the end of the Qajar era, and as well as from the 1960s where the Shah of Iran was trying to misguide people by misusing the power of Azadari, and what exactly happened and what was going on. Inshallah, I will cover and discuss all of these things in the first part of my presentation. Moving on, in the second part of my presentation, we'll be discussing the maqtil literature, the type of maqatil and the literature that was written regarding Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. But before that, I will talk about the idea of knowledge transmission. How exactly was knowledge transmitted within the Islamic civilization? What exactly was going on? And how that sets the precedent for the development of the maqatil literature, the maqtil literature of three different types, the religious, the historical, and the epics that were being written by different people of different categories, from the scholars, from the preachers, and from the storytellers. All of this detail will be covered in my presentation. Finally, I will go through 16 different works that have been written regarding Imam al-Hussein, actual maqatil, what they were, who wrote them. For example, the maqtil of Abi Mikhnef, the maqtil written by Sayyid ibn Ta'us al-Luhuf. Also, interestingly, a maqtil written by a Sunni scholar who lived in China in the 16th century. You know, what was this all about, and what category of the maqatil genre did it fall into? Inshallah, all of these details I'll be covering, ending with a couple of contemporary works that have also been written regarding Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Join me, inshallah, once again on August 21st and 22nd. Don't forget to check us out on our social media pages on Facebook and on Instagram. Please do check out these 8 recommended reads on the historical narratives on the tragedy of Karbala. You can find these images both on Facebook and on Instagram. I look forward to seeing all of you guys next week. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.